This is a Prado East Municipal fast-growing deaf and dumb football team comprising of 30 members. Football is giving them the chance to showcase their talents. Nana Owusu and his members' lack of recognition from event organizers remains the biggest challenge.
Another problem is that they went everywhere to help and to arrange the program. Anytime there is programming, they have to involve all deaf people to join for the arrangement so that they know what to do. About the woman match, they did not inform us, so they do not know that woman will play. All our women are not around to help. That is the other problem about that. Oh, no, not to be silent.
This opportunity to participate in the football games was availed to them by the Member of Parliament for the area, Francisca Oting Mensah.
Norm, which is going on, they shouldn't be left out. Everybody should be inclusive. That's inclusive governance. And so we thought it of engaging them as well. Fortunately for us, we have persons with disability club, which we inaugurated latter part of last year, and they've been very active, both as a club and then also helping in the society. So we thought of also engaging them, and it's also a way of encouraging others who have persons with disability people in their home, that the mere fact that you have a challenge or you have a disability doesn't stop you from doing other things that able people do. You can equally also do it just as they are doing. So it's also a way of encouraging others and also encouraging the persons with disability themselves to let them know that we cherish them and we adore them, and then they should be strong. We are with them in whatever struggle that they are going through.
The determination of these players proves once again that disability is not inability, but for them, the biggest challenge is their inability to understand what goes on in the field of play, especially when they are playing against the other side.
The problem is that the planning committee did not invite us to participate in the planning. So we do not know what to do. There is no interpreter here. If we visit deaf, you have to add some interpreter so that they can understand everything that is going on. That is this time. No, why? I run to help them. That is the whole problem.
There are other opportunities the Member of Parliament, Francisca Oting Mensah, says will be made available to harness their potential. She says one of the biggest challenges her outfit is working hard to address is the failure of some of them to read and write. This, she says, has done more harm to them.
I think one of them has to do with the fact that a lot of public facilities are not accessible to them. Some people go to the public office, and then if you are on a wheelchair, you don't even have a ramp to use. Sometimes if you are you are unable to talk, you find it difficult to even communicate, especially when you cannot even read and write. Those who can read and write, at least when they go to an office, they can write it on a paper and then you read. But then if you cannot read, you cannot read or write.
A report by Mahmoud Mohammed Nuruddin. Thank you.